Hello and welcome to TI Precision Labs. In this series, we will focus specifically on two types of redriver, linear and limited redrivers. These two types of devices can be applied in any differential high-speed interface application. Before we start with this presentation, if you are unfamiliar with the basics of signal conditioning, please review Introduction to Signal Conditioning first. Likewise, if you are unfamiliar with DisplayPort link training and USB, please review the What is DisplayPort video and the What is a USB redriver video. As discussed in the previous session, what is a signal conditioner? A high-speed transmission system includes a TX and an RX. The transmission media between the transmitters and receivers can be in the form of traces, connectors, and cables. Maintaining signal integrity for these high-speed signals over the transmission media is very important, but quite challenging. There are many factors that contribute to signal integrity degradation when a multi-gigabit signal passes through a transmission media. The signal integrity degradation can be resolved or mitigated through the use of signal conditioners. Because of the unbounded aspect of random jitter, it is not possible to eliminate all errors caused from jitter, but it is possible to achieve a targeted bit error rate, or BER. A signal conditioner, like redriver or retimer, can help correct jitter issues to produce a targeted BER. Use cases for a signal conditioner include extending a device's operating range to meet system form factor requirements and correcting a device's shortcomings. A redriver is one type of signal conditioner. In the simplest terms, a redriver is an analog component that provides a compensation of the attenuated signal using an equalizer function on its receiver side. In addition to the RX equalizer to compensate the frequency-dependent channel loss on the input side, it can also optionally provide transmitter linear equalization to compensate for the channel loss on the output side. When the channel loss is properly compensated, the result is a compliant signal at the sync's receiver. Redrivers can only clean up inter-symbol interference, or ISI, related deterministic jitter when it properly compensates for the channel loss through its equalizer function. Any under or over equalization would result in an additional deterministic jitter. Furthermore, any random and non-ISI related deterministic jitter will pass from the redriver input to the output. A redriver can be further classified into two types, a linear or a nonlinear redriver. A nonlinear redriver is also known as a limited redriver. If the output signal amplitude of a linear redriver is a near-linear function of the signal amplitude at its input for a certain range of input or output amplitudes irrespective of the output shape, then the redriver is termed linear in that input and output amplitude range. In the linear region, the output versus input signal amplitude graph appears as a straight line. The equalization gain determines the slope of that line. The steeper the slope, the greater the gain. This linearity range between the input and output persists up to a certain input amplitude. Once the linearity region persists up to a certain input amplitude, the compression region then marks the end of the linearity region. The compression region is a region which the output remains stable regardless of the input amplitude. A linear redriver is virtually a passive element in the signal path that, instead of creating frequency-dependent loss, it provides frequency-dependent gain. A linear redriver faithfully passes through all electrical characteristics of a source signal, just like a passive channel would, provided the signal is within the linearity range. The redriver does not address reflection and crosstalk in the system. The reflection and crosstalk are passed on from the input to the output. A linear redriver also amplifies the crosstalk along with the main signal, and therefore does not improve the signal-to-noise ratio. When the output signal amplitude is not a linear function of the input across a substantial amplitude, then the redriver is termed nonlinear or a limited redriver. A limited redriver is a redriver that has a transmitter with additional features that make the signal output nonlinear in relation to the input signal. These features typically include output swing control and output de-emphasis control. The de-emphasis control is used to compensate the loss of an output channel. In this particular example, we can see that this particular TX transmit equalization has a swing control that outputs a fixed 1 volt peak-to-peak differential voltage swing and three selectable de-emphasis settings at 0 dB, 3.5 dB, and negative 9 dB. The transition bit is when there is a difference between the previous and the current bit. When there is such a transition, the signal contains a high-frequency component. The consecutive bits are bits that show no difference between the previous and the current bit, and therefore contain a low-frequency component. Since losses increase with the data rate, the transition bit, which has a higher-frequency component, will be attenuated more than the consecutive bits, which has a low-frequency component. This disparity of losses between the high and low frequency causes adjacent symbols to interfere with each other. This is called inter-symbol interference, or ISI. The output pre-emphasis and or de-emphasis can be used to compensate for the ISI. A pre-emphasis is used on the transition bit to boost up the high-frequency components of the signal. A de-emphasis is used to attenuate the consecutive bits or the low-frequency components of the signal. Both pre-emphasis and de-emphasis work by minimizing the disparity of loss between the high and low frequencies of the signal. The DisplayPort link training is used to compensate for the signal integrity between the DP source and the DP sync. Compensation is done by changing the DP source amplitude and pre-emphasis level as requested by the sync. One advantage of using a linear redriver, with its ability to preserve the source's amplitude and pre-emphasis, is that the entire channel, from the source, the linear redriver, and the sync, is included in the link training. So the linear redriver does not interfere with the DisplayPort link training. The limited redriver, with its own amplitude and pre-emphasis, breaks up the channel and interferes with the DisplayPort link training. For USB 3.1, a certain amount of over-equalization is acceptable for the linear redriver. Over-equalization effectively becomes transmitter pre-emphasis, provided the swing is within linearity range of the linear redriver. This allows optimization between the USB required long and short channel support. But for the limiting redriver, this over-equalization results in uncorrectable jitter. There are also advantages that a limited redriver has over linear redrivers. Since a linear redriver output is a function of its input, a linear redriver requires the source signal's DC level at its input to be industrial spec compliant. On the other hand, with a limited redriver, the output is not a function of its received input. The limited redriver output voltage swing and de-emphasis or pre-emphasis can be adjusted in order to be compliant to the specific industry specification, even if the source signal itself is not spec compliant. To recap what we discussed, let's go over a short quiz. True or false? A redriver can clean up random jitter. The answer is false. Redrivers can only clean up inter-symbol interference related deterministic jitter. True or false? Linear redrivers have signal outputs that are a linear function of the input. True. The output signal amplitude of a linear redriver is a near linear function of the signal's amplitude at its input for a certain range of input and output amplitudes. True or false? A redriver is the same as a read timer. The answer is false. A redriver is an analog component that provides a compensation of an attenuated signal using an equalizer function on its receiver side, while a retimer is a mixed signal device that includes equalization functions plus a clock data recovery function to compensate both deterministic and random jitter to transmit a clean signal downstream. True or false? A limiting redriver has TX swing VOD and de-emphasis or pre-emphasis control. The answer is true. These additional features make the signal output nonlinear in relation to the input signal. Be sure to visit our E2E support forums at ti.com/E2E, where we can help answer questions about designing with signal conditioning interface technologies, such as linear and limiting redrivers.